If you were to reimagine policing, how would you change it?
I would make sure that the chief has the authority that he or she needs to discipline officers who violate the rules. I mean, now, if you're a bad officer and you betray your badge, the chief might get up there and testify against you.
To continue to apply that level of force to a person proned out, handcuffed behind their back, that in no way, shape, or form is anything that is by policy, is not part of our training, and it is certainly not part of our ethics or our values.
What if that was the norm from Maine to San Diego, from Florida to Washington, right? That you betray your badge, and the chief is going to testify against you, and the longest-serving officer on the force, Lieutenant Zimmerman, he actually testified in this case, and he said the force that George Floyd had to suffer under was totally unnecessary.
Pulling him down to the ground, face down, and putting your knee on the neck for that amount of time is just uncalled for.
What if that were the norm? That would change things quite a lot.
What has changed by this verdict?
What has changed is that people feel that change is urgently needed. It kind of reminds me of the newsreels I would see when the water hoses would be sprayed on African-American marchers in Birmingham and places like that. You know, just seeing that roused the conscience of people all over the country of all colors and said, this cannot happen anymore. Not in our country, not in the land of the free and the home of the brave. And the people are now gonna say, you know, we're just not gonna let it happen. And I can tell you, I know that folks like Tim Scott in the Senate, Republican, pretty conservative guy, he's working with folks like Cory Booker to try to get that George Floyd Policing Act through the Senate. But it's not a partisan thing. It is a standard of decency that we have to insist upon for everyone. What has changed is that people now saw in 9 minutes and 29 seconds what so many fellow Americans have been saying is going on since the inception of the country.